They say love is more precious than gold. It can't be bought and it can't be sold.
Hi, my name is Kay Mitchell. This is my husband, Roscoe Mitchell. We've been married 45 years. We met in May of 73 and married December the 21st of 73.
We met at the American Legion.
And let me tell y'all how we met. I was up there on the dance floor dancing, and I looked down the steps, and who did I see looking up? Under my dress, y'all. Under my dress. That's how we met, and I looked.
It wasn't me.
It was him. He always said, that wasn't me. It was him. But that's how we met, and he come and asked me to dance afterwards. We danced, and we ain't been separated since.
When she walked through the door there, the American Legion, I told my friend that was sitting with me, I told him, I said, there she is. I said, I've got to have that woman. And I got her. We went to that carnival. And while we was there, one of my old girlfriends came running up to me and grabbed me by the arm and took me over to ride some kind of ride. And I told her, I said, I can't do this. I said, I got a girlfriend that's waiting on me over there. And she just kept on and on and on. Finally, I told her I had to leave. I had to go back.
Yeah, because he was fishing to get in trouble.
And when I got back to her, there was fire coming out of her house.
7 months we got married. But I knew I loved him. And whenever we first met and I took him to meet my mom and daddy, my daddy found out how old he was. He was 36 and I was 18. He said, oh, no, you're not. I said, oh, yes, I am.
We pick at each other a lot. And so far, she's got the best of him. But the pillow deal. But I'd have to go in there in the bedroom in the dark. But I went in there and I lay down in the bed and I laid my head down on the pillow and it was so cool, you know, and soft. And I said, man, this feels good, you know. I got up and I went in the bathroom and I had to pass by the mirror and I glanced up at the mirror and I went on by and I stopped and I backed up. And I looked in that mirror, and I said, what in the world? My hair was spiked up, because I had took a shower before I went to bed, and that powder soaked in my hair, and it was spiked up, you know. And my eyes was bloodshot red, and the rest of me just solid white, you know. I said, this is not me. I said, I don't know what it is, whether it's a demon or what it is, but this is not me. And I bent over and looked in the mirror real close and looked in my eyes, and I said, them are not my eyes. So I went in there and woke her up. I said, baby, wake up. I said, there's something wrong with me. I said, look at me. She had her head covered up, and I felt a bed shaking. And she was just dying laughing. You know, she was laughing so hard she couldn't tell me what she had done. She pointed over there to the pillow. And I looked at that pillow, and it was just covered with baby powder. I said, I will get you.
Robert asked him, he said, I want you to record this, Miss Kay. He said, because we're going to get him. He said, Roscoe, will you What does that say on that can right there? And he picks it up, and it's a Budweiser can. Somebody throw it down. He said, what does that say? Roscoe had it up there like this, and it looked like he was taking a drink, well, and we took a picture of it. And he was supposed to be voted on being a deacon the next weekend. Robert Sherry said, yeah, this is how your deacon spends his vacation. Yeah.
And guess who got the first message? Brother Terry.
It's our trust in the Lord.
Yeah.
You know, our faith.
He put us together.
He's kept us together.
And he's been with us. We've been through some hard times, especially in the last 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
But he's been right there with us all the time.
Always trust one another. You have to have trust. Mm-hmm. Your trust. First off, you have to have the Lord in your life. You have to have your faith. Then you have to have trust in one another. You know, you have to be able to trust each other to, but that's the main thing, you know, you just
you have to do things together.
Yeah.
Do everything together. There's nothing we don't do together. You got to put Jesus first, and he'll take care of the rest.
Yeah, in the 45 years we've been married, we've may have had 5 arguments. We don't argue. It's not part of us. You know, it's just we know what each other's thinking a lot of times. Yeah. Too, so.
But if we get mad at each other, I'll go outside and stay about 10 minutes, and then I'll come back in here and do something to make her laugh.
Yeah.
And everything's all right then.
Yeah.